The police are on the spotlight in Gulu City for allegedly working closely with street criminal gangs to steal, destroy, and in some unfortunate circumstances, kill residents. Alfred Okunga is the Gulu City mayor. He has today spoken up about the involvement of the security officers, especially the police, in the current insecurity in his city.
There are some elements of the security personnel who are benefiting, and some individuals who are benefiting from these street gangs, street children who are now turning criminals, and I would like to condemn that kind of act in the strongest term possible, because these people go and kill, these people go and rob, these people go and steal, which really, as a human and adult who is upright, should not be encouraging these children to commit crimes.
In the recent years, street criminal gangs have emerged in Gulu City and have come to be known as Agu. Some of the gangs are armed with guns.
One day, the UPDF were conducting an operation in my area, but I saw two police officers alerting the street gangs that they were about to be arrested. Onek Godfrey, the LC1 of Laibi Sale, was attacked and detained by street criminal gangs in 2019.
In 2022 alone, security apparatus led by the Uganda Police, the UPDF, and the Office of the Resident City Commissioner conducted an operation that led to the arrest of over 300 young people.
Revelations included their children and the youth. Those who derive their livelihood from the streets are being used for economic motives. For instance, we've seen scrap dealers using them to sort of like snatch or get scrap off the streets and are sent to steel rolling mills. We've also seen some restaurant owners using them to probably get some sort of like livestock to use in their restaurants, as per the research that we came up with.
Michael Ojok is the co-founder and the executive director of Hashtag Gulu. The organization was founded about 5 years ago in order to help rehabilitate street-connected children.
Ask about their family details. So when we find such, there are instances where we've been able to facilitate mediation processes. So we do this to make sure that young people who have run away from home go back and live at home.
The emergence of street gangs in Gulu City has been blamed on poor parenting, effects of the LRA war, and poverty.
In 3 years, we've been to over 200 homes across the Acholi and Lamu sub-region. Parents can be focusing on providing for the family, getting school fees, but that means interactions that the mother or father would have with their children takes a back seat, because provision ranks higher in terms of their priority.
Now it's like maybe we are taking the actions, because sometimes, you know, you go for an operation and then you find these kids have run away. So there is now a kind of, people are being suspicious in the team. Who is doing this? Could it be police? Could it be? So there is not yet, there is no proof. If we become close to our children, we can be able to tell that there is a problem somewhere, and problem known is problem solved.
Jane Francis Amongin Okili, the Gulu City Resident Commissioner, has committed to investigate the connection of security leaders in operations of the street criminal gangs. I'm Joseph Omagor, reporting for the news in Gulu City.